know that everyone calls me the Candyman. But you, my friend, you can call me the Candyman. I see that you were able to make it here unscathed. For the most part, I hate for anything to happen to my favorite customer. You'll have to pardon, but don't be afraid if you hear any drones or patrols. The Candyman and the security here have a mutually beneficial relationship. I supply them some of the candy that they crave, and they loosen their security measures just enough. Oh. Since business has been booming lately, I'm in need of an associate or two. So I'd like to ask, with you being my number one client and as much as you know about myself and the goods that I provide, how would you be interested in becoming, working with the Candyman and helping me to deliver some of the goods to various clients all across the multiverse? The next time you and I meet, how about I show you what I do and we can package up some orders for a client, and then you could take them and deliver them. I can't guarantee your safety, but I can supply you with some contacts who can give you the gear necessary for you to protect yourself. So let's say maybe a month's time from here, a month or two, and you'll be the Candyman's apprentice. Does that sound appetizing? Great. Have a deal. Excellent. Well, I suppose we shouldn't delay the reason for us being here any further than we have to. So, let's get down to business. Here is a Eisley. Here. Smells wonderful, doesn't it? That's for you. Probably want to wash that down, or wash samples that I have for you. Gotta watch your sugar intake there. It's, how long has it been since your last dose of sugar? That long? Okay. Well, we'll try to take our time here and go easy. All right. Let me get my water out here. Some Innsmouth peanut brittle. Happens to be the favorite of, what's that fine gentleman's name? Obadiah Marsh, I believe. Well, Marsh family. I happened to find a recipe from a confectioner that used to work out of there, and combined with the peanuts that grow in Innsmouth and that fine water from the Bay area makes for some of the finest peanut brittle you've ever had. So even those frog people, what do they call them, those fish people, deep ones, yeah, there you go, you can have a sample there. Sample myself. Let's see. Nice piece. There we go. Bon appetit. Think. Delicious, yeah. processes. And forget the lady's name. And the one they call the one. Yeah, that's his name. Faces of the folks recently freed from the Matrix. Whenever I arrive with a new batch of candy and assorted confections, they've never tasted anything so sweet before. So, of course, that's a whole new clientele base just waiting for me. Customers. Let's get this open here. There you go. You have a sample of that. Oh, you're welcome. You don't have to thank me. Mistaken. I believe that this might taste like a mix of banana and mint. Bon appetit. No banana. You know, I should know all of my confections and their ingredients by heart, but when you travel through the multiverse and through as many rifts that I've been through, it starts to take its toll a little bit. So what do you think? Don't you just love how they start off a little firm, then they just melt right in your mouth? Very strong, minty flavor. Really good if you have bad breath. Cimmerian chocolate covered potato chips. Don't you just love that word? Potato, 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 potato. Say it with me. Are from Cimmeria, home to a very famous barbarian by name of Conan. Quite a wonderful place there. A lot of interesting folks sat down. He actually is also a customer of mine. There you go. Now you can take a few. Now we sat down. He was telling me a few yarns and tales. Like I said, no need to worry. They know I'm here. They know I'm expecting you. So, like I said, I give them a couple samples and they let their security measures lax a little bit for a little while. Chocolate covered potato chip. Who'd ever thought chocolate and potato or salted potato chip would go together so well? Cimmerians sure know how to grow those cocoa beans. That and the Derry and their potatoes. It's one of the best chocolate covered potato chips I've ever had and probably you'll ever have. It's a nice sound, isn't it? But anyway, as I was saying before, we were rudely interrupted by those delicious chocolate-covered potato chips. That Conan fellow was just waxing on and on about all of his tales and strange creatures from other worlds that roam the lands of Hyperborea. Some strange elephant man or elephant god lives in a tower, I think. Pirates and a large ape-like beast. A giant snake. So many strange things. You should take a visit there. One time. One day. Make it a week's vacation. Let's continue, shall we? Wonderland, assorted gummies. You know of Wonderland, don't you? Alice, she fell down a rabbit hole. She took a visit there. Yeah, the Mad Hatter, the Cheshire Cat, the psychotic Queen of Hearts, and a lot of other rodents are cage-free. Okay. Gummi ice cream cone. Sample of those. Take as many as you like of each. Well, take one of as many as you like. Ah, gummy pig, good choice. Gummy teeth. And a gummy chicken foot. Okay, I'll take one myself. Zombies now, but they still have some memories of who they used to work for. In any case, gummy chicken foot. It tastes just like real chicken feet. The skin to the toenails, the claws, right down to the bone. Agent Cooper, I believe, FBI agent, loves it. Also a client of mine. Then there's Alara Palmer, I believe. Poor girl. And a few other folks there. Have you ever been inside that red room? I don't know if it's real. I stayed over one night at this lodge. Just had this weird dream about it. There was a little person dancing, and it's just very strange. But I was able to capture the essence of that town and use it as my main ingredient. Thus the name Twin Peaks Vanilla Fudge. So if you ever happen to want to visit someplace aside from Wonderland, maybe visit Twin Peaks first. Go, you can have a sample of that. That's fine. Okay, you're good. Okay. It's almost like the other. Innsmouth candy. You can almost taste Twin Peaks. You can smell it. That mystery, that madness almost. Don't you just love how the fudge melts right in your mouth? It's sweet, it's a little on the rich side. One little square will keep you satisfied for a while. And that Twin Peaks essence in combination with that vanilla flavor. It's just marvelous, isn't it? Reminds me, just before my arriving here, I came from Arkham Sanitarium, I believe you might be familiar with. There's a Professor Clemens that works there. He's the head of the facility. I'm not sure what his specific title is. I told him about my dream, because, you know, this job sections, and he provides me with the moment to me to unload all of the things that bother me, you know, the things that I've witnessed. And I told him about this dream I had from Twin Peaks, this red room, and he was quite intrigued by it. He was even thinking that he might have to simulate this red room himself and test it and experiment with it on the various patients. Sounds interesting. I might have to go check that out in person. Maybe you might want to as well. Anyway, let's continue, shall we? Chuck, he's not too bad. He a heart of gold. That guy's just, you gotta sympathize for him a little bit. He's a pirate. He's probably suffering from a little PTSD, like most pirates do, from what they have to endure. He's like a slab of coal. You know, he's hard and ugly outside, but you get to the center and he's a diamond. I know it doesn't really work like that, but I think you get the picture. He has a heart of gold. Once you get to know him, and you have about 6, maybe 7, 8, 10, 12, 13, 15, 20, you know, a couple hundred beers with him, you know, not so bad. Sorry about that. Anyway, have a sample, won't you? Yeah, they're stuck together. There you go. Okay. I think that one is mint, that green. Yeah. Sample of the banana flavored. It's good, isn't it? Thank you. spitting contest. Of course, I didn't win, but it was fun nonetheless. Small town in the on the world of Earth, planet Earth, in a what's it called? A state called Maine. Derry, Maine. Yes, Derry, Maine, United States of Russia, United States of Mexico. United States of America, you're familiar. A very strange town, or reminds me of Arkham, Innsmouth, Twin Peaks. A lot of strange tales and goings on. One of my best clients there is a clown. I gotta tell you though, between you and me, okay? I don't like to speak bad about my clients, but this clown, creepy ass clown, creepiest I've ever seen. I mean, Dick doesn't take care of his teeth. He's always, I mean, every time I go to deliver my goods to him, he's always down in the sewer. What kind of clown lives in the sewer? I don't know. Apparently, he's always harassing some kids. Now, I don't know if he's that kind of clown. Because if he is, I might have to stop doing business with him. But there's a rumor that he eats children. He's like some clown straight out of, Hansel and Gretel or something like that. I don't know. But, hey. His money is good. So. No. Anyway. Derry, gummy, pizza slices. Okay. Go. You can have a sample. I believe it's, sample bag together. I should have got pepperoni, sausage, vegetarian, even white pizza. Sicilian too. Should have grabbed up some of that next time. Okay. delicious, ain't it? You can taste the crust. It's almost crispy, even though the gummy is soft. You can almost taste how crispy the crust is. And the tomato sauce. I think the Oompa Loompas and Willy Wonka's great, 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 great 50th generation granddaughter now runs the place. Well, she hardly ever there. I think that's the one recipe they want from me. One. I'll just break off a bite, actually. You can almost taste the desolation of Mordor with every bite. And those Mordor cocoa beans and Derry. The sweetness offset with the crunchy graham cracker. That itself is devoid of almost all sugar. Some sodium in it. Yeah, that sweet and salty combination. It's wonderful. Well, my friend, I believe we are down to the last two items. Gallifreyan Pop Rocks. You are familiar with Gallifrey, home to the Time Lords, to the Master, and to another woman, I forget her name, the Rani, or something like that. Great clients, all of them, the Master as well, and all the different Time Lords. They have been really wonderful customers, each and every one. The fourth doctor, my personal favorite, though. You familiar with the Time Lords? Do you have a favorite doctor? Okay. Anyway, we have Gallifreyan cotton candy pop rocks. And bubblegum flavored. What would you like to try? The bubblegum or the cotton candy? Tough decision. Similar. Okay, once you hold out your hand, okay. Just tell me when. A little bit more. Okay. I, on the other hand, will have some of the bubblegum. my friend. I hope you enjoyed all of those samples. It's now time for me to place your order, or to take your order. So bear with me a second. He's a deep one, on those fish people. Hate to say that, but saltwater taffy, pop rocks, pizza gummies. Satan wants some peanut brittle, saltwater taffy, and mint rolls. Have you ever been to hell? Misconception of it being a lake of fire and suffering, and actually it's a paradise. It's almost as beautiful as the forests of Endor. Yeah, except without any of the Ewoks. Satan. Big line. Another one, Jesus. Jesus wanted quite a lot. Graham crackers, peanut brittle, pop rocks, etc. Ever been to heaven? Not a bad place. Everyone up there, you know, quite pretentious, self-important. Hell seems to be more laid back. Down to earth. Okay. Patient 9901034 just wants some graham crackers. Patient one. Some of these folks are over at Arkham Sanitarium. Patient one. No, he's like the Arkham Sanitarium greeter, so to speak. Wants some gummies and some vanilla fudge. Another patient, 633-4772, wants some saltwater taffy and some peanut brittle. Save the best for last. Okay, so why don't we go through? Let's see, we have the pop rocks. Would you like some of those? Okay. How much? Minimum quarter pound. There's no max. Half a pound. Okay. Bubble gum or the cotton candy. Half a pound of both. So, yeah, okay. Half a pound of both. Pop rocks. Chocolate covered graham crackers. No interest in those. Okay, that's fine. Let's see, what else do we have? Chocolate covered potato chips. Yeah. How much? Half pound. Yeah, quarter pound. Okay, quarter pound. Chocolate covered potato chips. Potato. was just those particular flavors that I brought. If you still like the base crunchiness of that flavor, of that crust and the marinara flavor that we use, but would like sausage or, you know, meat lovers, or so you like half pound of pizza gummy slices, half mushroom, half pepperoni, half of a half of a half, okay, half pizza gummies, half pepperoni, half mushroom, okay, let's see what else, vanilla fudge. Did you want some of that Twin Peaks vanilla fudge? Yeah, okay. How much? 2 pounds. 2 pounds. Twin Peaks. No fudge. Okay. The Wonderland gummies. You'll pass on those. Innsmouth peanut brittle. Yeah. Half a pound. Half pound. Innsmouth peanut brittle. Okay. The Booty Island saltwater taffy. Would you like some of that? You're not sure. There's all kind of flavors. I can just get you a 1 pound box of assorted flavors. Same consistency, just, you know, and same authentic flavors. There's mint, there's chocolate, pistachio, elephant, xenomorph, kraken flavored, on and on. Assorted. Probably get about a dozen, maybe 3 dozen. I'll get some of the finest flavors, okay, that are most requested. All right, okay. It's a 1 pound box, assorted Booty Island salt water taffy. We had the Zion mint rolls. Not too big on mint, that's fine. Yeah. Okay, I think that was it. All right, I got your order right here, and I will have that. And I'll have all of this time. And again, like I said in the beginning, pardon me. What'd you think of the Mo's Eisley water? You can keep that, by the way. Well, you're my last customer for the day, as I said. My day's not over yet. I gotta go back to the factory. Fortunately, I can't tell you where our factory is, as even though you are my favorite client, and I trust you, and you've been prompt with your payments, and you've been referring other clients as well. and safe, and they're not going to harass you or anything. And hopefully, I wish you safe travels on your way back home. It was a pleasure doing business with you, as always. I gotta go back to the factory and get my orders into the system. It was still a one-man job, but like I said in the beginning, if you're looking for some work, I'll be back in about a month or two, and I can show you the tricks of the trade and what I do to fulfill the orders. I could sure use the help. Okay, so think about it. Your order delivered here. You know the location, same pickup, same drop location as before. And then I'll see you in about a month or two, and you'll be the Candyman's, you know, apprentice. All right. Again, pleasure doing business with you. Stay safe. Please, if you know anybody looking for, you know, some of the finest confections in the multiverse, send them my way.